Hello, welcome back. And here now we'll see about the dot product and cross product of this vectors. So what is this dot product and the cross product? We have a very simple difference between this cross product and the dot product. So it's nothing but we are going to find the product of two vectors. So if I find the product of two vectors, so I say, if I'm finding the product of A vector and I'm finding the product of B vector, and if I end up as a scalar quantity, it is called as dot product. And similarly, if I'm finding the product of the two vectors and the product of two vectors I'm getting as a vector quantity, it is refers to the vector, or it's a cross product. So dot product can also be given as scalar product, okay, or this is can be given as a vector product. So dot product and this cross product are just we'll be using in various problems to represent. You will learn in the forthcoming lectures why this dot product and cross products are used. So if to be much more simple, let me take previous example or previous representation of A vector and B vector and show you how this dot product and cross product will be treated or formulated. So I'll take A vector as AY vector plus AZ vector. Then the next B vector I am taking it as BX AX vector plus BY BY vector. Wait, just a minute. This is AY vector. Then BZ AZ vector. Okay, I have taken two vector quantity. Let me see how the dot product functions and the cross product functions. So in case of dot product, the formula of A vector dot B vector, it is represented as dot, and it is given as modulus of A vector into modulus of B vector into cos theta, where theta is the angle between A and B. And this can also be reformulated as AX BX plus AY BY plus AZ BZ. You can also represent, if you know the value of AX and all the A coordinates in the A and all the coordinates in the B coordinate systems, then you can directly multiply and give it answer. So if you probably see this, you will end up with a scalar quantity. And if you want to find the theta value, which is nothing but A vector dot B vector divided by, it's just we have arrived the formula, so I can directly show you how we have arrived. So from this equation, if I want to know what is cos theta or just theta, it is going to be cos inverse of A vector dot B vector all divided by modulus of A vector into modulus of B vector. So this is con. Okay, so if A vector is parallel to B vector, then A vector dot B vector will be equal to what? Parallel is theta is equal to 0 degree. So if theta is 0, cos theta is again 1, so you'll end up with only the magnitude A vector magnitude by B vector magnitude. But in the similar cases, if A vector is perpendicular to B vector, then that A dot B vector will be 0 because the value of, because you know the theta value will be 90 degree and cos 90 is 0. So you have this value to be taken. And from which you can now find all this, like, you know, you can find the dot product value. So now what is a cross product? Cross product. So cross product can be given as, let me tell you here, the cross product. The cross product, which is represented as A cross B, is given as modulus of A vector and modulus of B vector into sine theta An vector. So since I told you that the product of two vectors, if it ends with an vector itself, so this is by which we say it's an ending of this whole value is ending with a vector quantity because of the unit vector. So it is called as a cross product. So in this cross product, we can find using the formula A vector modulus into B vector modulus into sine theta an. So there also this A cross B can also be represented as, this A vector cross B vector can be represented in terms of matrix, where in the first row we'll write it as the unit vectors AX vector, AY vector, AZ vector. The second row we will write the components of A. So it is AX, AY, AZ. And in the third row we'll write the components of B, which is BX, BY, BZ. So this is the vector representation or the matrix representation for the cross product. Okay, so this is can also be done. So you know how to do the vector, the vector cross multiplication. So from this we can also write, I'll write the final, like by doing the product of this matrix, I'll write it again. So it is given as AY PZ minus AZ BY into AX vector plus the next term, which is AZ BX minus AX BZ into AY vector plus the last term, which is AX BY minus AY BX into AZ vector. So this is a way how you can represent the cross, you can formulate your cross product both either in these two form, whether A modulus, B modulus into sine theta into AN vector, or you can represent in terms of a matrix where we have 3x3 matrix, we'll get a 3x3 matrix, then you can do this. And the next thing, what you want to know is about how to find the distance between two points or something. Because, and in general mathematics, you already know, like if suppose I have a point P here and a point Q here, and the coordinates of P in terms of coordination is x1, y1, z1, and for Q is x2, y2, and z2. The distance between P and Q, the distance between P and Q given be given as x2 minus x1 the whole square plus x1 minus x2 square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square plus z2 minus z1 the whole square, the whole root. So this will give you the geometrical distance between P and Q. Similarly, for the same thing, in the vector quantity, you can also find the distance between the two points, or you can find the vector values or the unit values. Okay, so the next lecture we will see about how we are going to write the problems.